Search engines thrive on understanding relationships between entities. Whether it's how a person connects to a company, an article, or other content, the better search engine grabs the connections between entities, the more effectively they can rank and present relevant information. And in case you want to learn more about entity SEO, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Anyway, the person schema markup is a way to tell search engines about a person, be it an individual or a fictional character. Typically, you need to add the schema markup that looks like this on your page. The more individuals you have on your page, the more codes you need to add, and it can get complicated. But as a RankMath user, everything is straightforward. So if you have an About Us, a company info page, a team page, or a keynote speakers page on your site, let me show you how to easily add the person schema to those pages. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, typically when you publish a piece of content, RankMath adds the author information in the article schema that connects the person who wrote the content. But we are not talking about that. We are talking about adding the person schema for each individual in the Meet the Team, About Us, or Keynote Speaker pages. So let me show you an example of how to add multiple person schema to this page, which is Group 1's team page. The first thing you need to do is to make sure that on your RankMath's dashboard, the schema structured data module is turned on. And thereafter, as you visit the intended page to add the schema, you can go to RankMath's tab, select the schema option, and click on the schema generator. And the person schema is right here. Now on Group 1, there are 10 executive and non-executive leaders and 8 commercial leaders. But for the example, let's focus on the 10 leaders up top. So on this page, here are the info of all the 10 leaders. So on the schema generator, let's click on the person schema and add it to the page. And since there are 10 people on the page, let's add 10 person schema. And we are done. Of course, you can add as little or as many person schema markups as your use case requires. But take note that if you are a free RankMath user, you can only add one schema type for each page. So if you need to add multiple schema types, such as in this case, consider upgrading to the Pro version. It has a lot more other features which we have discussed on our channel. Anyway, once done, let's talk about what information to add to each schema fields. Now there are schema fields for the free version and a set of schema fields for the pro version, but let's first talk about the fields for the free version. So firstly, any schema fields that are marked with this red asterisk are mandatory fields. So if there is nothing added to the field, your schema markup will not pass the rich results test. And in this case, the headline field is the only mandatory field. And by default, the headline field and the description field takes information from the SEO title and description fields in the edit snippet right here and here. And if you did not add any text to this title field, by default, this variable takes information from the page title. The same goes for the description field, where it takes information either from the page excerpt or the first paragraph of the page or other places. So at any point in time, the mandatory headline field in the person schema will not be left empty. But we shouldn't keep these as default because it just doesn't make sense. First, this headline field is meant for you to add the name of the person or a headline that contains the person's name. So the first person on our page is Daniel. So we will add his full name here. Next, the description field is self-explanatory. You add text that describes the person. You can click and expand this if your description is long. It can be the same text as you have on a page, or it can be a more concise description of the person. Let's move on to the email field. We will come back to this shortcode after we have completed all the schema fields. So this is self-explanatory as well. You will add the person's email address. A business email is preferred. Now this is a hypothetical address, alright? So don't use this to contact Daniel. Next are the address fields. Now this depends if your executives or individuals want to keep their residential address private. But I would think that this is mostly going to be the address of the company they work in. So in this case, this will be Group 1's address. Now for the country, it needs to be in the ISO 3166 codes, which are the two letters that represents the country. For example, the United States is US, Canada is CA, and for Sweden, it will be SE. So on the country field, I will add SE. Next will be the gender field. You can add male or female, but schema.org also accepts any string of text that describes the gender. For example, if the gender field describes a sports team with both male and female, you can write mixed, or you can also add non-binary. But for Daniel, this will be male. And then we have the job title. This should be straightforward. Daniel is the Chief Executive Officer of Group 1. So I will add that here. Now, if you are a free Rank Math user, these are the schema fields that will be available to you. But if you are a pro user, you have the same as schema fields that will link the person's other pages on the web to this profile, such as their social media accounts, their personal websites, or whatever. This same as schema is crucial for search engines to understand how different pages and entities on the web relate to the person. So let's click on Add Property. You can ask your executives for their social media profile links, like their LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram profiles. And in this case, Daniel's LinkedIn profile is this. But if for some reason the person does not have any social media profile, blogs, etc., you can use pages from business listing sites that includes the person's information. For example, pages from ZoomInfo or Crunchbase. And with this, the search engines will know that the information from these pages describes the person on this page. And now that we have completed Daniel's person schema, let's click Save for this post. And now, you need to give me a moment while I add the information of other team members. And we are done. Now the thing is, instead of having custom text for each individual, we can use the schema information instead. Let me show you how. So for example, we want to add the schema information into this section that describes the person. Instead of the custom text, let's remove this, as well as this. We can visit the person's schema. You can see the shortcode here. Let's copy and paste it here. Now, each person's schema will have a different shortcode, so we have to copy and add them accordingly. Let's edit two for an example, and let's save this page. And on the back end, it will look like this, but if you visit the page, these are all the schema information added. Well, it is up to your personal preference to display the schema information. And if you don't wish to, you do not need to add the shortcode to the page, and the schema will still work in the background. And now it is the moment of truth. We need to know if the schema markups we have added to the page actually works. So let's test it. So what we will do is to test the page source code on the schema.org validator. On the page where we have added the schema markups, let's right click and select view page source. And then we want to hit Ctrl or Command A to select everything, and then Ctrl or Command C to copy the source code. Next, we will visit schema.org validator 2. This is the link. We will select the code snippet option and paste the copied codes here. Let's test it. And here we go. We have 10 items in the person's schema, and there are no errors or warnings, which means that the schema markups we have added works. So with this, I hope you have a clear understanding of how to add the person's schema to your pages. But if you still have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below and we will help you out. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from Rank Math. I'll see you in the next video.